Hello, and I speak with Mr. Kirby, please.
Yes, speaking.
Yeah, Mr. Kirby, it's Kunselier's here calling you from Springs.
Your name again?
Kunselier.
Mr. Selier.
Yeah, calling from Springs. A notification of a book called The Secret Letters of Jan van Riebeek. This book was written by you, huh?
Yes, that's right.
Why in the book then do you refer to Maria van Riebeek as a drunkard?
Why didn't you like that, Mr. Selier?
Because the facts, in fact, I'm sure that you did research on this book, would show that she was not a drunkard.
So yes, but it's a book of humor, Mr. Selier. It's a book of humor.
Yeah, but you see, you mustn't forget that Jan van Riebeek was now one of South Africa's most foremost not politicians, but foremost founders.
Foremost founder? That sounds like tautology. He was a founder, anyway.
He was a founder. This is right. And to state in a book form that his wife now was a dronklap or drunkard is, I think, a bad taste.
Do you find it offensive?
Yeah. Also, I also am a former school teacher. And to think and to state in book form that van Riebeek also was homosexual.
I don't think that's actually stated in the book, but nonetheless, if that's how you want to read it, that's up to you.
No. Not that.
A former school teacher. What were van Riebeek's dates, Mr. Selier?
I beg your pardon?
What were his dates? When did he come to the Cape?
When did he... I can't... We're on a bad line. When?
When did he come to the Cape? How long was he at the Cape? Where did he come from? Where did he go to after he left here? I mean, you're a school teacher. You should know these things. I mean, you're going for accuracy.
Mr. Kirby, you know...
Kirby, not Kirby.
I said, Mr. Kirby, you're not trying to establish whether, in fact, I'm stupid. Your problem is you're thinking everyone's stupid by calling Maria van Riebeek, the wife of Jan van Riebeek, now dronklap, by indicating that Jan van Riebeek was homosexual.
No, possibly a suppressed homosexual, but, you know, you strike me as one of those people who want their history to be like a Holiday Inn lavatory, you know, with a paper strip around it saying sanitized for your protection. Do you like your history that way, Mr. Selier?
No, but I like facts, I like figures, and I like them to be correct. And I think when writing about one of the most treasured peoples of our country, Jan van Riebeek, for you to take the opportunity in book form to categorically state that Maria van Riebeek now is a drunkard. To state that he is a homosexual.
I didn't state he was a homosexual.
You indicate.
Are you a suppressed homosexual, Mr. Selier, that you read that?
Mr. Kirby, I'm not phoning you here for you to insult me. I'm phoning you here for
you're shouting at me, Mr. Selier.
Because you're
telling me I'm being offensive.
You now turn and said, am I a homosexual?
I think there's something you have to understand. You know, being offensive has become the South African way of life. We're all offensive. You know, under the National Party, which I'm sure you vote for, this country has become offensive to the entire world. Haven't you realized that for more than 40 years, we've been totally disgusting to everybody else in the world? So we've come to believe that it's the appropriate way to behave.
Why?
I'm just behaving like a South African.
Why could you not write about Jan van Riebeek, the real person? Why has he now got to be a morphy? Why has Maria got to be a dronklap?
I never called him a morphy, but that's your reading of it.
You indicated that he was a morphy. You indicated that he had a homosexual tendencies. You indicated that Maria...
Would you tell me where? Chapter and verse.
Let me just find this book here.
Okay.
I can't now, you know, on a phone try now and decide, tell you where and what page it was. But you keep referring to where Maria said, "Pass me the bottle of rum," as she was drunk again. You know, I mean, this I think is disgusting.
I'm so sorry. I forgot. When did they canonize her? Is she Saint Maria von Rendsburg?
No, she's not. But she was most definitely not a drunk club.
She was definitely not a drunk.
And he was most. Jan van Riebeek was a first-class sailor. He was most definitely not a sailor of modern times who had homosexual tendencies.
The next thing you're going to tell me is that I'm anti-Afrikaans.
Well, you most probably are.
Oh, please. You know, really and truly, at least 10 of my best friends are Afrikaners.
Yeah, but you know, that's what they all say, don't they? They always say, but my best friends are now Afrikaners.
So do you speak on behalf of the Afrikaner nation?
No, but I will speak on behalf of a whole... a lot of people would be totally offended.
Tell me, by the secret letter... Which part of the Afrikaner establishment do you represent? I mean, are you a Van Zyl Slabbert Afrikaner? Are you Andres Trionicht Afrikaner?
No, I'm a
Barenstrader? Are you a Nas Butter establishment?
Yeah. I'm an Afrikaner. The Secret Letters of Jan van Riebeck, translated and edited, and I've got a book in front of me by Robert Kirby, is slanderous. It is something that should be taken and the scrap from all children of a certain age in this country.
Well, why don't you take your complaint to the censors? You know, they're specially designed to deal with things which give offense to people.
This book is here, it should not be read by people of a certain age group in South Africa, because the kids now are learning history of Maria van Riebeck being a dronkard.
But aren't the people intelligent enough to realize the whole thing is a send-up?
Robert, this is John Berks.
You shit. You shit, it isn't.
My word of honor, it is.
Ha 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 ha